Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Jack Dee.
Thanks so much, that was great. So it is, it's great to be here. Thank you very much for turning up. Yeah, thank you, right. I like you. Yeah. I mean, how many of you are actually from this area, Hammersmith? Oh, okay, a smattering of you, yeah. All the ones that could afford it. It's nice, it's great. I like the area. And, you know, I've been on tour for some time now, and everyone always says, well, you know, what's it like on tour? What's it like on the road? And to be honest, you know, it's very very long journeys in the car, listening to CDs, staying in hotels endlessly, live off room service and mini bars and watching late night movies. I get to see my kids every 2 or 3 weeks, and I speak to my wife most days on the phone. It's perfect. I don't know why I didn't think of it years ago. It's just relationships are so much easier from a distance. You know, miss you too. Send. Oh, the boiler's packed up. There's no hot water. Hot water in hotel. Fine. But anyway, I was out there on the Broadway, and I got approached by this guy. I don't know, if you live around here, you might have seen him yourself, but this guy is just standing there swinging a plastic bag around his hand, a carrier bag. And he's just standing there, just on the side of the road. I don't know what was in the bag, but, you know. And he was too old to be doing this, let me just say that at the start. You know, when you're 8 or something, you can do that on the way home from school, can't you? This guy's 40 at least. He's standing there. And his trousers right up there, all tight. And I knew that this guy was going to talk to me. Because people like that always do, right? As soon as he sees me, he goes, can I have a pound? All right. I said, what? Can I have a pound? I said, what do you need a pound for? He said, oh, I can't get home. Right. And I thought, oh, come off it. Who in this day and age can get home for a pound? You know, isn't it a pity? You know, if he had said to me, look, I'm awfully sorry to trouble you. I've lost my wallet. I need to get back to Islington. My wife's going to get me from the station. I have to get the dry cleaning. £35 would cover it very nicely. And I think, well, here's someone I can trust. But a pound? What are you going home in? A shopping trolley? And I never found out what was in the bag either. It's been bothering me ever since. Could have been the severed head of a well-meaning local social worker, you know. Do you ever get that little frisson of pride when someone asks you directions? I do. I don't know why. It's kind of a bit silly, but I do. And I have a story I want to tell you that happened to me a few weeks ago. But I have to warn you, the story involves using a foreign accent, if I can be allowed to do that. And I just wanted to warn you that, because the foreign accent is very important. The story makes no sense without it. I just want you to know that. I don't want you to think that I'm getting cheap laughs off the back of someone who's with a foreign accent, because that's not what I'm about. And I hope you know. Yeah, no, well, come on. I'm not a racist. You know that about me. My God, I'm not a racist. I've never owned a bed and breakfast. How can I be? I'm just. And I'm not a taxi driver, so, you know, just... for me, they're the worst every time. Taxi drivers, I don't know why they think, because they're in charge of the vehicle, that they can impose their values on you in that way. We wouldn't put up with it in any other form of transport. You wouldn't sit on an aeroplane, would you, and the pilot comes out on the tannoy. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our first officer speaking. Just currently cruising at 30,000 feet and just crossing the west coast of Africa. Yes, it's like spot the white man down there. Okay. You wouldn't put up with it on the train, would you? You know, mind the gap and your wallet. This used to be a nice area. Not anymore. So I'm not a racist, you know, and mind you, the term racists, I feel, gets bandied about rather a lot these days, perhaps too often, and I like to see everyone's point of view, you know. I have some work done in my house at the moment. I've got a plasterer doing some plastering, as they do. And I was talking to him, and I said, how's work? How's work going? He says, it's not so good. It's drying up, really, a bit. And I go, No. Get the fuck out of here. I had the good sense to ignore it when he said it. I was hoping you would as well. Anyway, he says, and I said, what's the matter? And he said, it's all the immigrants coming in. You're Eastern Europeans, you're Estonians, you're Poles, and that, you know, right? Now, you know, and that, in certain circles, that turned you on, did it? Well, something for everyone in this show. In some circles, that could be considered as racist. But then I thought, well, hang on, put yourself in his shoes, Jack. Put yourself in his shoes. How would you feel? How would I feel if I turned up tonight at the Hammersmith Apollo and the manager had been at the stage door and said, Jack, sorry, we haven't got anything for you here. We're going to have to let you go because we've got this Polish comedian on, Jack Dee, and... and he's very, very good. We, you know, he's just so much more miserable than you. We just don't, I'm trying to see it that way, and you know, and he doesn't. Anyway, so yeah. So I'm in Leicester Square 2 or 3 weeks ago. I'm in Leicester Square, and there's a Japanese family who are lost. They're looking around. I can see they're lost. The dad's got the map out. He's looking around, and he looks up and he sees me. And he approaches me, right? And like I say, little frisson of pride. I feel pleased that he's chosen me, you know, out of everyone in Leicester Square. Yeah, I feel pleased that he has identified me as the friendly face of London. And he comes up and he goes, excuse me, can you please tell me? I think I went to quite a lot of effort to explain there was an accent coming up and that, yeah. Can you please... He didn't have his hands like that, I'm not sure, you know. That was that. I'm not proud of that, And I can, you know, obviously, he's there in front. I knew he's Japanese anyway, straight away. You can tell, can't you, from the, he had the... What did he have? He had a flag on his arm. Japanese flag on his arm. I know my flags. I know my flags. He goes. Can you not with his hands like that? He didn't have his hands like that. He wasn't doing that. That's a bit of subconscious stereotyping coming through there. I'm not proud of that. This is what happens. He goes. Can you please tell me a way to Singapore? Right. And I had no clue what he said, right? Which is, this is difficult for me because I really want to help. You know, I'm proud of being a Londoner. I want him to have a great time and his family, but I simply did not hear or understand what he said, right? Now, bear in mind here, if I'm asking directions, I work on a three goes in your...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.